varmt välkomna till den här manifestationen, den årliga gemensamma arbetarrörelsemanifestationen till minne av de 600 svenskar som reste ner till Spanien.
Svarta tupp, tror du du vunnit? Säg mig vem slipade sporren? Svarta tupp, tror du du vunnit? Säg mig vem slipade sporren? Den röda tuppen har aldrig dött, ni möts kanske imorgon. Den röda tuppen har aldrig dött, ni möts kanske imorgon. Vinden ska föra bort min sång om jag sagt vad ingen får höra. Som natten, snart blir din tid att förblöda. Svarta tupp, tupp svart som natten, snart blir din tid att förblöda. Den svarta tuppen är stor, men segrar ej över den röda. Den svarta tuppen är stor, men segrar ej över den röda.
I feel honored and moved to find myself here with you, commemorating those who fought in the ranks of international brigades. We have no such monuments as you have here in Poland, but I hope one day we will have, and we battle and struggle for the opportunity to have one. Today Poland is rewriting history. Street names are changed to celebrate right-wing role models. Catholic or nationalistic monuments, square and memorials appear like out of nowhere to cover up traces and memories of the people of the left or lately fighters of Warsaw Ghetto Uprising. In Poland every 7 hours a person is attacked because of their unfamiliar looks. Racism, xenophobia, sexism seem to be under protection of establishment. By allowing for eradication of memory of people who are torchbearers of equality, emancipation, solidarity, the anti-fascist struggle, we have allowed the right-wing historical narrative to dominate the social discourse. Polish citizens fought in Spain, they had a motto, for your freedom and ours. It means not only the fight for freedom as independence, but also emancipation, social equality, the rights of women, minorities and workers. I'm a visual artist, a painter and an activist. I make installation and performative actions. And in my work, I stand against manipulating memory. Hannah Arendt wrote, the visibility and equality go hand in hand. It is this visibility that we must stand and fight for, to keep restoring it. On one of my actions was the first commemoration of the International Brigade in Poland after the fall of the Berlin Wall. I started a broader fight for the memory of the International Brigades in Poland. It all began in a small town covered with the poster of ONR, which is a radical nationalist group. They were celebrating the Day of Disavowed Soldiers. The disavowed soldiers are the forgotten soldiers, those we didn't speak about, soldiers who were fighting for independence of Poland. The 1st of March has become a celebration of the right-wing historical narrative. A critical moment came when I returned to Warsaw. Polish flags hanged before 1st of March, and they organized rehearsal before the celebration. Those were visual traces of an imposed oppressive narrative to which there was no visible response. This is why I began working to restore the memory of people, such as my grandfather, the Dombrovskis, in the public discourse. I decided to include them into the narrative about disavowed soldiers. In the 90s, the plaques which with the inscription commemorating the battles fought by Dombrovskis in Spanish Civil War was removed from the tomb of unknown soldiers and from any other monuments in Poland. This is a clear sign of fragmentation of historical memory. In 2016, the 1st of March, the official day of remembrance of disavowed soldier has become a national holiday and has been a feast of the right-wing propaganda ever since. 2016 also marked the 80th anniversary of the start of the Spanish Civil War. They fought for the freedom of Europe during its first clash with fascism, and then for independence of Poland on many fronts, in lots of anti-fascist movement and partisans around the world. My performance created a moment to incorporate the Dombrovskis, currently erased from memory and forgotten, into the circle of disavowed soldiers. I decided to copy the typical rituals, like the governmental delegation who came to the tomb to commemorate. I prepared a tricolor wreath, the flowers of which were composed into the symbol of the flag of international brigades, and replicas of flags of 13 international brigades from Poland. One of them I brought here with me, it's this one, it's the flag of the Naftali Botwin, the banner of the group in which my grandfather fought. We paid the tribute to Dombrovskis, lying the wreath at the tomb of the unknown soldier, just as any official delegation would. Then someone read a famous poem about international brigades, glory and dynamite. Through that action, I was able to seize the public space and demonstrate that the tomb should be a memorial of collective history of Polish citizens fighting for the freedom and independence on different fronts of war and remain independent despite the changes in the current political mood. I believe that we are part of those people as they are part of us. As a result of this art action, certain changes have been initiated. For instance, the new left-wing party was afraid to support my artistic activity and promote the values of the fighters for the Spanish Republic. After that, they have changed their line in this matter, and so the fight of the memory began. The media started to devote more and more attention to the brigadiers. Numerous groups organized to protect street names of the Dombrovskis, the last remnant of the international brigades in the Polish public space. The next step was to bring back the memory of women who fought gun in hand on many fronts in defense of the Spanish Republic. And when they were deprived of the opportunity to take part in the heroic struggle, they provide support by working in hospital, kitchens, transportation, education and culture. I have constructed my story, which I was going to tell here, but we have no space for this, but I'm keeping repeating this story in schools, in public demonstrations, so people start to being aware that women were also fighting up there. Because in Polish books, in most of narration, there are only heroic struggle of the guys. And really lots of Polish citizens, women, went there and fight. So by this performance, I included art pieces with collages and different things to let people imagine how it happened. And I have great pleasure to show you Jan Melchior, which is here with us. He is the son of one of my favorite of the Dombrovskis fighter, Moriska Melchior. The Dombrovskis wrote in their manifestos, "When Madrid falls, Warsaw falls too. They fought for your freedom and ours. In our geopolitical situation, we should not only restore and keep the memory of them alive, but also defend the ideas they fought for. As philosopher says, democracy is always the democracy to come. We still have no chance to learn, we still have a chance to learn one from another, and we are fortunate enough to resist the authoritarian wave in conditions of peace. Unlike them, we do not have to change the world gun in hand, but we need to stay united, just like the inter-brigadier soldiers. Salut Raptor Republika, no pasaram."
Ljuset, och livet allt vi vill jag bli. Sista striden.